जी अस्सलाम वालेकुम। BS इंग्लिश 6th सेमेस्टर कॉमिटी ऑफ मैनर्स, मोस्ट वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू। होप यू आर ऑल फाइन एंड कूल एंड एंजॉयिंग गुड हेल्थ। टू डेज यू हैव टू प्रेजेंट योर टॉपिक्स, आई मीन असाइनमेंट्स, एंड यू हैव टू प्रेजेंट योर प्रेजेंटेशन। होप यू आर रेडी एंड well prepared to present over here. Whose turn is over here? And please, तो आइए start लेते हैं। Who is the first drop of rain? आप सबको आवाज क्लियर आ रही है मेरी?
यस सर, आ रही है जस्ट सर।
ओके, तो कौन है who wanna present first of all today? अलीना, यस प्लीज स्टार्ट कीजिए।
ओके सर। अस्सलाम वालेकुम, रिस्पेक्टेड सर एंड माय डियर फेलोज। माय नेम इज अनिला एजाज एंड द टॉपिक ऑफ माय डिस्कशन इज द कैरेक्टर एंड द समरी ऑफ द प्ले पिग्मेलियन। फर्स्ट वी डिस्कस द इंट्रोडक्शन। पिग्मेलियन इज अ प्ले बाय जॉर्ज बर्नार्ड शॉ, हु बोर्न इन 26 जुलाई 1856 इन डबलिन आयरलैंड, who was an Irish playwright and co-founder of the London School of Economics, who wrote more than 60 plays, and he died in November 1950 at the age of 94. Pygmalion is a play by George Bernard Shaw that tells the story of poor young flower girl who has been disrespected and overlooked because of her appearance and the dialect she speaks. Now we discuss the characters of the play. First, Eliza Doolittle, who belongs to an upper middle class and who is very aggressive and disrespectful, selfish. Eliza Doolittle is the main character in the story. She is first introduced as an unpolished, full-mouthed flower girl, but is transformed into a beautiful woman. Next, Professor Higgins, Professor Higgins is a linguist who believes he can transform Eliza Doolittle into a duchess in 6 months. He's an intelligent man, but he's also disrespectful to others despite their social class and extremely arrogant. Next character is Colonel Pickering, who belongs to middle class. Colonel Pickering is a linguist who challenges Professor Higgins to transform Eliza Doolittle into a duchess. Colonel Pickering funds Professor Higgins' work with Eliza and is considerate and kind to her. Next character is Alfred Doolittle, Alfred Doolittle is Eliza's materialistic father who tries to obtain. Next, Mrs. Higgins. Mrs. Higgins is a Professor Higgins' mother who disagrees with Higgins and the Pickering's plan to try to change Eliza into duchess. Next, treating his foot heel, who is 21 years old. Mr. Hensford Hill, Freddie meets Eliza during a meeting with his mother and sister at Mrs. Higgins' house. He falls in love with Eliza and writes letters to her. Next, Mrs. Hensford Hill. Mrs. Hensford Hill is the mother of the Clara Hensford Hill and Freddie Hensford Hill. Mrs. Hensford Hill belongs to upper middle class and she feels bored and ashamed of her daughter's reaction.
Excuse
Next, Clara Hensford Hill.
Excuse me. Sabko awaaz clear aa rahi hai ji?
Ji sir, clear hai.
Okay.
Clara Hensford Hill is aggressive, disrespectful, selfish, impulsive, and pathetic. She belongs to an upper middle class and she behaves badly. She is not married. Next character is Nepomuk. Nepomuk is old student of Higgins. She thinks Eliza is a foreigner because of her perfect accent. Next, Mrs. Pierce. Mrs. Pierce belongs to lower middle class and she is Higgins' housekeeper. She believes in good manners and she is rational, calm, respectable, and sensible. Next, we discuss the summary of the play Pygmalion. Pygmalion opens with two linguists, Professor Higgins and Colonel Pickering, placing a bet on whether Professor Higgins can transform the life of flower girl Eliza Doolittle by helping her learn to speak proper English rather than her Cockney dialect. Two gentlemen met in the rain one night at Covent Garden. Professor Higgins is a scientist of phonetics and Colonel Pickering is a linguist of Indian dialects. The first bets the other that he can, with his knowledge of phonetics, convince High London society that in a matter of months he will be able to transform the Cockney-speaking Covent Garden flower girl, Eliza Doolittle, into a woman as poised and well-spoken as Duchess. The next morning, the girl appears at his laboratory on Wimpole Street to ask for speech lessons, offering to pay a shilling so that she may speak properly enough to work in a flower shop. Higgins makes merciless fun of her, but is seduced by the idea of working his magic on her. Pickering goads him on by agreeing to cover the cost of experiment if Higgins can pass Eliza off as a duchess to an ambassador's garden party. The challenge is taken and Higgins starts by having his housekeeper bath Eliza and give her new clothes. Then Eliza's father, Alfred, though his real intent, Alfred Doolittle, comes to demand the return of his daughter. Though his real intention is to hit Higgins up for some money, the professor, amused by Doolittle's unusual rhetoric, gives him £5. On his way out, the dustman fails to recognize the new clean, pretty flower girl as his daughter. For a number of months, Higgins trains Eliza to speak properly. Two trials for Eliza follow. The first occur at Higgins' mother's home, where Eliza is introduced to the Hensford Hills, a trio of mother, daughter, and son. The son, Freddie, is very attracted to her and further taken with what he thinks is her affected small talk when she slips into Cockney. Mrs. Higgins worries that the experiment will lead to problems once it's ended, but Higgins and Pickering are too absorbed in their game to take heed. A second trial, which takes place some months later at an ambassador's party and which is not actually staged, a resounding success. The beggar is definitely won, but Higgins and Pickering are now bored with the project, which causes Eliza to be hurt. She throws Higgins' slippers at him in a rage because she doesn't know what has become of her. thereby bewildering him. He suggests she marries somebody, she returns him the higher jewelry, and he excuses her of ingratitude. The following morning, Higgins rushes to his mother in a panic because Lisa has run away. On his tail is Lisa's father, now unhappily rich from the trust of a deceased millionaire who took to heart Higgins' recommendation that Doolittle was England's most original moralist. Mrs. Higgins, who has been hiding Lisa's upstairs all along, chides the two of them for playing with the girl's affection. When she enters, Lisa thanks Pickering for always treating her like a lady, but threatens Higgins that she will go working with his rival phonetician, Nipoma. The outgoing Higgins cannot help but start to admire her. As Lisa leaves for her father's wedding, Higgins shoots out a few errands for her to run, assuming that she will return to him at Wimpole Street. Lisa, who has an overlong sweetheart in Freddie and the wherewithal to pass the dishes, never makes it clear whether she will or not. That's all from my side. If you people have any question, you can ask.
Okay, fantastic. If somebody wanna ask question, do ask question. Overall, the presentation style was fantastic and well prepared. Big hands to you. And do write the comment. Do write the comment in the chat box, please. MashaAllah, well done. Okay. Yes, who is the next presenter, please? Shuma.
Yes, sir. Mai present karu. Okay, sir.
Nanji kijiye, present kijiye. Maria Yunus, main wish tabassum hai, jo bhi pehle karna chahta hai, it's up to you.
Okay.
Wish karne hai.
नहीं आप कर ले
ओके अस्सलाम वालेकुम क्लास द टॉपिक आई एम टॉक टू यू अबाउट टुडे आर द थीम्स ऑफ अ प्ले रिटन बाय जीबी शो
थ्री थीम्स आर रेडी फॉर प्लीज प्लीज वुड यू लाइक टू शेयर योर स्क्रीन प्लीज
ओके सर
इफ यू हैव सम रिटन कंटेंट डू शेयर विद अस
Three themes are very important in this play. First one is language and speech. Second one is appearance and identity. And third one, last one, is social class and manners. All these themes play a vital role in our lives. To live a good life, we desperately need all three of these. First of all, I would like to discuss
excuse me. Language. Excuse me. ये जैसे थीम्स ऑफ द प्ले है तो और किस किस का यही टॉपिक है ताकि एक थीम एक
सर,
बंदा डिस्कस कर दे दूसरा थीम
जी जी निमरा शहर का है शहजाद भाई का है करम का और मुसव्वर का
करम मुसव्वर निमरा शहजाद एनी वन ऑफ देम इज प्रेजेंट ओवर हियर चलें आप स्टार्ट कीजिए अगर कोई यस यस प्लीज
Sir, after Maria, I would like to present my topic.
You want to present this one topic?
No, sir. After Maria, I'm saying okay, after Maria.
Okay, next one. ठीक है जी. Carry on, Maria.
Okay, sir. Language and speech. हम जो जेबी शाह के लिखे हुए इस प्ले पिग्मेलियन का एनालिसिस करने जा रहे हैं सबसे पहले राइटर इंट्रोड्यूस करवाता है कि उसका हीरो प्रोफेसर ऑफ फोनेटिक्स
आपने पहले शेयर की थी स्क्रीन, बट उसके बाद अभी डिस्प्ले नहीं हो रही। सबको डिस्प्ले हो रही है?
नो सर।
हाँ कुछ जी। हाँ जी क्लियर हो रही है जी।
सबसे पहले राइटर इंट्रोड्यूस करवाता है कि उसका हीरो प्रोफेसर ऑफ फोनेटिक्स है। फोनेटिक्स इज द साइंटिफिक स्पीच, राइट। उसने लैंग्वेज की वैरायटी को इंट्रोड्यूस करवाया है। ये एक एक्सपेरिमेंट था जिसमें एक लेडी की किस तरह से ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन की गई कि एक लोकल एक्सेंट बोलने वाली फ्लावर गर्ल को डशीज की फॉर्म में प्रेजेंट किया और एक स्टैंडर्ड लैंग्वेज डायलैक्ट सिखाया। इसमें हम दो तरह की चीज़ें देखते हैं कि किस तरह प्रोफेसर हिगन्स को अपने ऑक्यूपेशन के ऊपर इतनी कमांड थी कि उसने अपने एक बेस्ट फ्रेंड से चैलेंज किया कि ही कैन ट्रांसफॉर्म एनी पर्सन। वो किसी भी पर्सन को ट्रांसफॉर्म कर सकता है, किसी भी लोकल एक्सेंट बोलने वाले को स्टैंडर्ड डायलेक्ट सिखा सकता है। सो वी कैन से डैट ही इज़ अ मैन ऑफ फोनेटिक्स एंड कैन आइडेंटिफाई एनीवन। इंसान के एक्सेंट से आइडेंटिफाई कर सकता है कि ये किस बैकग्राउंड से बिलोंग करता है। सेकंड वन, वो ये चीज क्लेम करता है दैट ही कैन चेंज अ लोकल एक्सेंट इनटू अ स्टैंडर्ड एक्सेंट। इसके इसके एक्सपीरियंस से हमें ये पता चलता है कि हर इंसान में लर्निंग की एक एबिलिटी मौजूद होती है, उसे एक अवेलेबल कंडीशन और इन्वायरमेंट चाहिए होता है अपनी स्किल्स को डेवलप करने के लिए, अपने टैलेंट को पॉलिश करने के लिए और नॉलेज को एक्सप्लोर करने के लिए। क्योंकि सीखने की सलाहियत तो ऑलरेडी इंसान में मौजूद होती है ना। तो जी बी शो ने हमें अपने इस प्ले में ये मैसेज दिया है कि कोई भी इंसान अपने माइंड से लोअर कास्ट और अपर कास्ट का होता है, लोअर क्लास और अपर कास्ट क्लास का होता है, वो चाहे तो अपने आप को निखार सकता है। ये प्ले उन लोगों के लिए है जो अपने अपने माइंड में एक इमेज क्रिएट किए होते हैं अपर क्लास और लोअर क्लास की। जैसे कहा जाता है ना कि जिस लैंग्वेज का एक्सपोजर मिलता है इंसान को, वही लैंग्वेज उसमें ग्रो कर जाती है। तो बेसिकली इट इज अ प्ले अबाउट इंग्लिश स्पीच। द प्ले इज बिल्ट अराउंड द प्रोफेशनल लाइफ ऑफ हिगन्स एज अ फोनेटिशियन एंड हिज एबिलिटी टू कन्वर्ट अ फ्लावर गर्ल इनटू अ डशीज बाय गिविंग हर अ न्यू स्पीच। Within a few months, Eliza gets a new speech and starts talking so well that people think that she's Duchess. So that play affirms G.B. Shah's views that speech is one way of dividing class from one class to other. That's all from my side. अगर किसी को कुछ समझ नहीं आई इसमें से तो पूछ लें।
No, fantastic. निम्रा, बट देयर आर कुछ प्रोनाउंसिएशन इधर से फोनेटिशियन वाज नॉट अ फोनेटिशियन, इट वाज अ फोनेटिकियन, फोनेटिक फोनेटिक्स से ओके। तो और बाकी ओवरऑल ठीक था। राइट योर कमेंट्स इन द चैट बॉक्स ओवर निम्रा सहर। यस प्लीज, मैं विश द बेस्ट।
मैं प्रेजेंट करूं सर?
ओके सर।
नाउ मैं विश तबस्सुम इज ओवर हियर। इट इज
इसके बाद निमरा
जी।
ओके कैन आई सर?
यस प्लीज। वालेकुम अस्सलाम।
बंद करना इसको। Assalamu alaikum class, my name is Mahvish Tavassam and today the topic of my presentation is plot and themes issues of the play The School for Scandals. Okay, I'm going to start a presentation and start sharing my screen. Is it visible to you?
Yeah, yes, visible.
बोलना नहीं है बात लोगों ने. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डिस्कस द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द प्ले द स्कूल फॉर स्कैंडल. दिस इज अ प्रोलॉग.
एक्सक्यूज मी, इसको पोर्ट्रेट लॉक खत्म कीजिए इसको. Yes, please.
One second. Let me change the room, sir, please. First of all, introduction. The prologue is written in rhymed couplets by an actor, playwright, producer, and theater manager whose name was David Garrick. And the prologue questions whether anyone needs any instruction in gossip and rumoring, saying that society is completely saturated by it. Members of society read about each other in the newspaper's gossip column and laugh at their friends while becoming indignant when the gossip is about themselves. This play will then attempt to attack scandal in the same way a warrior tries to defeat a monster, although the playwright is unlikely to win in this battle. This was an introduction. And before talking about plot, I would like to discuss characters of this play so it would be easy to all of you guys to understand the plot in a better way. The first character is Lady Sneerwell, who is a wealthy widow and whose job is to spread false news. And she hires a person named Snake to create false letters from a person, Charles, to her. And the next character is Snake, who works for Lady Sneerwell. Third one is Charles Surface. And that character wants to marry another character, female character, Maria. And Lady Sneerwell loves Charles Surface. And Charles Surface is very extravagant. But he does not have a good reputation. The next character is Joseph Surface, who is a brother of Charles, and his reputation is good, but he is in actual very hypocrite and liar. And he also wants to marry Maria for money. He is a wicked one and selfish. Next character is Sir Peter Teasel, and he spent all the life as a bachelor, but later on he marries a young lady who is younger than her, and is known as Mrs. Teasel. Next one is Mr. Rowley, who is confidant of Mr. Peter Teasel. He shares everything with Mr. Peter Teasel, and Mr. Peter Teasel shares his secrets with Mr. Rowley. Next character is Sir Oliver Surface, who is the uncle of Charles Surface and Joseph Surface. And later on he becomes Mr. Premium for Charles Surface to judge him, and Mr. Stanley for Joseph Surface to judge him also. Can I ask questions about the characters? Excuse me. Am I audible to you?
जी जी, क्लियर आवाज आ रही, बताइए जी.
ओके, कुड यू पीपल टेल मी हु इज जोसेफ सरफेस एंड अबाउट हिज पर्सनालिटी और अबाउट हिज ट्रेट्स.
चार्ल्स का बड़ा भाई है
जी,
जिसको दिखावे का और प्रॉपर्टी का, वेल्थ का, ये सारी चीजें इसको बहुत पसंद है.
और ये सेल्फिश है और हिपोक्रेट भी है, लायर है.
लायर है, यस. एंड ही आल्सो वांट्स टू मैरी मारिया फॉर मनी.
जी
जी,
ओके. एंड कुड यू टेल मी हु इज सर पीटर टीजल?
वो जोसेफ के और चार्ल्स के अंकल थे,
सर पीटर टीजल
ओके सॉरी
पीटर टीजल जो हैं ये लेडी टीजल के हस्बैंड हैं
यस यस एंड ही इज वेरी ओपन
जी और ये जो प्ले स्टार्ट होने से जो है 7 मंथ्स पहले इनकी शादी होती है पीटर टीजल की लेडी टीजल के साथ
यस एग्जैक्टली ओके नेक्स्ट नाउ मूविंग टू द प्लॉट ऑफ द प्ले सो द प्लॉट फॉर स्कैंड द स्कूल फॉर स्कैंडल्स बिगिंस इन द ड्रेसिंग रूम ऑफ लेडी स्नीरवेल हु इज अ वेल्दी विडो विद अ पेंशेंट ऑफ फॉर प्लॉटिंग एंड स्प्रेडिंग रूमर्स Lady Sneerwell has hired Snake to forge letters for her and place false stories in the gossip columns. They discuss her plot to stop Charles Surface, whom she loves, from becoming engaged to the heiress Maria. Lady Sneerwell is conspiring with Charles' older brother Joseph, who has a reputation for goodness but is really a selfish hypocrite and liar, and who wants to marry Maria for her money. Snake departs and a group of gossamering, including Joseph, Mrs. Candor, Sir Benjamin Backbite, and Mr. Crabtree congregate at Lady Sneerwell's house. Maria is also there, but she rushes from the room in distress when the other gossips about Charles' enormous debts and final financial misfortunes. And the next scene introduces Sir Peter Teasel and his confidant, Mr. Rowley. Sir Peter Teasel, Peter has lived all his life as a bachelor, but 7 months ago, married a much younger woman. He and Lady Teasel fight all the time, and Sir Peter is sure his wife is always to blame. He complains of the bad influence that Lady Sneerwell has on his wife. He is also upset because Maria, who is his ward, does not want to marry Joseph. Sir Peter, who served for some time as a guardian to the Surface brother, is convinced that Joseph is an exemplary young man with strong morals, and he believes that Charles is not only badly behaved, but also bad deep down. Rowley disagrees. He thinks Charles is wild, but will grow up into a good man. Rowley delivers the news that Sir Peter's old friend, Sir Oliver Surface, has arrived back in England after 16 years in the East Indies. And the second act begins with a quarrel between the Teasels in their home. Lady Teasel wants large sums of money to buy luxury goods. Sir Peter reminds her that she grew up simply and lived with none of the things she now says she needs. Lady Teasel says she remembers that boring life well. After his wife leaves, Sir Peter marvels at how attractive she is when she argues with him. Okay, guys, tell me how many years later Sir Oliver Surface is going to visit them. How many years later Sir Oliver Surface is going to visit Sir Peter Teasel and his nephews or
nieces? You want to say the reunion of a nephew and uncle?
Yes, sir.
The gap of years when जब वो इंडिया गया फॉर और फिर वापस आ रहा था कितने साल हुए वुड एनीबॉडी एल्स लाइक टू आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन ओके प्लीज कैरी ऑन चैट बॉक्स में आंसर्स लिखते जाइए
एट लेडी स्नीवेल्स द गॉसिप नाउ इंक्लूडिंग द टीजर्स आर लाफिंग एट देयर एक्वेंटेंसेस अपीयरेंसेस एंड मिसफॉर्च्यून्स Maria and Sir Peter find this gossip appalling while Lady Teasel joins in with the others in making jokes at others' expenses. Away from the others, Joseph tries to convince Maria to consider him as a potential husband, but she refuses. Although she says she knows from all she has heard that Charles is not fit to marry her, she will not consider marrying his brother. Lady Teasel, who has been considering taking Joseph as a lover, enters the room to find Joseph on his knees in front of Maria. He makes an excuse, and after Lady Teazle sends Maria from the room, begins to try to seduce Lady Teazle, but she is not sure whether to trust his explanation of what she saw. Okay, here a point we got that Joseph tries to flirt with Lady Teazle and also with Maria, and he has an affair with Lady Teazle also. Next scene, Rolly brings Sir Oliver to see Sir Peter's house. They rejoice at being reunited, and Sir Peter gives Sir Oliver his impressions of the Joseph and Charles, who are his nephews and potential heirs. Sir Oliver thinks that the description of Joseph that Sir Peter gives is too good to be true. They think that Joseph is a good man and he would be heir of all the property of Sir Oliver. Next, Sir Oliver hatches a plot to test his nephew's characters and choose an heir. When Sir Oliver left the country, Charles and Joseph were too young to now remember what he looks like. And Sir Oliver plans to use this fact to test them. He plans to go to Charles disguised as a moneylender named Mr. Premium to see how extravagant Charles really is. To test Joseph's alleged morality, he plans to visit his older nephew in the guise of a poor relative who needs charity named Mr. Stanley. I have discussed about it early with all of you guys. Now, Rowley introduces Sir Oliver to Moses. Moses is also a character who is a Jewish moneylender and who will help Sir Oliver surface to visit Charles, who will accompany him to see Charles, and the two men leave to call on Charles. Left alone, Sir Peter immediately gets into an argument with Maria, who says she will not obey his command to marry Joseph. Maria runs from the room and Lady Teazle enters. Sir Peter proposes that they should stop their quarreling, and his wife agrees. But when he tells her that she was always the one to start their fights in the past, they begin to fight again. Sir Peter accuses Lady Teazle of having an affair with Charles surface, a rumor that Snake and Lady Sneevel have been spreading. She indignantly denies this and leaves. Sir Peter is infuriated, especially because Lady Teazle never loses her temper when they fight. Next, Sir Oliver, pretending to be Mr. Premium, arrives with Moses at Charles' house, where Charles is drinking and playing cards with friends. Charles appeals to Mr. Premium for money, explaining that although he has sold off all his property, he expects to be the heir of the fabulously wealthy Sir Oliver. Charles suggests that Mr. Premium can collect the debt when Sir Oliver dies. Mr. Premium presses Charles for other collateral, and Charles suggests that he can sell him the family portraits. Inwardly, Sir Oliver is shocked at the disrespect this shows to family tradition, but he bids for the portraits in an auction. As the auction nears its end, Sir Oliver asks if Charles will sell him a specific portrait. Charles refuses, saying that it is the portrait of his generous benefactor, Sir Oliver. It touches Sir Oliver's heart, and he forgives Charles for being so extravagant. In the next scene, Lady Teazle arrives late for a date with Joseph at his house. She complains about her fights with Sir Peter, but it's still unsure whether she wants to commit adultery with Joseph. Sir Peter arrives and, terrified of being discovered, Lady Teazle hides behind a screen in Joseph's room as Sir Peter makes his way up the stairs. Sir Peter confides in Joseph that he is worried his wife is having an affair with Charles, but that he plans to soon give her financial independence from him. which he hopes will ease their fights. Sir Peter begins to talk to Joseph about his desire to marry Maria, but Joseph tries to stop him, not wanting Lady Teazle to learn that he is courting Maria too. At that moment, Charles arrives. Sir Peter says he will eavesdrop on the brothers to discover the truth about Charles and his wife. Sir Peter tries to hide behind the screen, but Joseph stops him, explaining that he already has a lover hiding there. Sir Peter hides in a closet. Instead, Charles enters and Joseph asks him about Lady Teazle. Lady Teazle, Charles denies any involvement with Lady Teazle and begins to say that he believed Joseph and Lady Teazle were the ones having the affair. Joseph stops Charles by telling him Sir Peter is listening. Sir Peter comes out and tells Charles he is very relieved. Joseph leaves the room for a moment and Sir Peter tells Charles that his brother has a woman hidden in the room. As Joseph returns to the room, the screen is pulled down to reveal Lady Teazle. Although Joseph tries to explain Lady Teazle's presence there, Lady Teazle tells her husband the truth. She was considering having an affair with Joseph, who she now understands is a liar and hypocrite. She says that even she had not been discovered, she would have changed her treatment of Sir Peter after hearing how kindly he spoke about her. Soon after the Teazles leave, Joseph is visited by Sir Oliver, who pretends to be a poor relative named Mr. Stanley. Joseph speaks politely and eloquently about charity, but he tells Mr. Stanley that he has no money to give and that the rumors that his uncle sends him large sums of money are false. Under his breath, Sir Oliver says that Charles will be his heir. After Sir Oliver leaves, Rowley arrives to tell Joseph that his uncle has returned from the Indies and that he will bring him to Joseph's house soon to see him. Joseph curses the bad timing of his uncle's arrival. At Sir Peter's house, the Gosprenging have gathered to try to find out what really happened between the Teazles. The servant refuses them entry, so they stand in an afternoon untrumped, arguing about what the real story is. Some believe that Sir Peter caught Lady Teazle with Charles, while others allege that it was Joseph. They also report that Sir Peter was wounded in a duel fought with the wife, stealing Sir's brother, but there is no consensus about whether swords or pistols were
excuse me please. Ab next lecture kiska hai, iske baad aapka is lecture ke baad lecture kiska hai?
Sir Fakir ka.
Sir Fakir.
Sir Fakir
link share ho gaya unka? Abhi unka link share ho gaya. Kitne baje start
ho gaya? Sir time ho gaya, bas 2 minute hi kar denge.
ओके
सर 4:15 होता है स्टार्ट.
ओके बाकी महवेश इज इट ओवर?
नो सर.
हां कैरी ऑन प्लीज.
ओके शुड आई?
यस प्लीज.
ओके Rowley and Sir Oliver arrive to tell Sir Peter to come to Joseph's house for the meeting between the Sir's brother and Sir Oliver. Rowley pleads Lady Teazle's case, saying that he spoke to her and she feels terrible for the pain and embarrassment she caused him. Upon Rowley's urging, Sir Peter decides to reconcile with Lady Teazle. At Joseph's house, Lady Sneerwell complains that Joseph ruined her chance to disrupt Charles and Maria's engagement by getting caught pursuing Lady Teazle. Joseph tells Lady Sneerwell she may still have a chance with Charles because Snake has forged letters that suggest Charles has pledged to marry Lady Sneerwell, which should also ruin Charles' chance with Maria. Sir Oliver and Charles arrive, and Lady Sneerwell hides in the next room. The brothers wish to make a good impression on Sir Oliver and try to force the man they believe to be Mr. Premium or Mr. Stanley from the room, fearing what he will say to their uncle about their behavior. Sir Peter, Lady Teazle, Rowley, and Maria arrive, and the Teazles reveal to the surface brothers that the man they are throwing out of the house is their uncle Oliver. Joseph tries to make excuses for his behavior, but Charles only apologizes for having disrespected the family by selling the portraits. Sir Oliver tells Charles he forgives him everything and Joseph that he sees through his hypocrisy. Lady Teazle suggests that Charles may also be interested in gaining Maria's forgiveness, but Maria says that she knows he is already engaged to another. Charles is dumbfounded. Lady Sneerwell emerges from hiding to claim that Charles is engaged to her, but Rowley summons Snake, who reveals that he has paid to forge letters for Lady Sneerwell, but paid double to reveal the truth to the Rowley. Lady Sneerwell storms from the room in frustration, and Joseph follows. The play ends with an engagement between Maria and Charles, who will be his uncle's sole heir. So should I present the themes?
जी प्लीज एक आध थीम्स जो है ना क्योंकि लेक्चर स्टार्ट होने वाला सर के इसके एक दो मेन इंपॉर्टेंट थीम्स जो है ना प्लीज
द फर्स्ट थीम ऑफ द प्ले इज गॉसिप and gossip is perhaps the most central theme of the school. For scandals, gossip or rumors may be true or may be false. In general, however, gossip is spread by both unofficial channels, word of mouth, and official channels, newspapers. Since word of mouth spreads faster, gossip is mostly spread in the play through that channel, but it is clear from discussions between characters that the spreading of rumors through the newspaper has a particular way of spreading information far and making it seem credible. The main rumor spread in the play is that Charles and Lady Teazle are having an affair, spread purposefully by Lady Sneerwell, Joseph, and Snake. But that was false. But other rumors arise and circulate as well, such as Charles' death, Joseph and Lady Teazle's affair, and Sir Peter being wounded in a duel. Next, the most important theme is... Yes, you can say money, because all of the characters are Joseph and...
Okay, thanks a lot. Amavish, fantastic presentation with the fantastic preparation. One thing is more important I would like to share. You have a God gifted voice of good presenter. Okay, your ample gaps and reading style is overall fantastic. Big hands for you. And write your comments about Mavish Davasu. And the rest presenter will must present their presentation in the next lecture. Okay, तो इससे पहले कि हमें makeup lecture लेना पड़े, next lecture में सब presenters जो है ना अपनी presentation present करेंगे, right? Do write the comments about the presenter. मैं विश तो बस हूँ. Fantastic, मैं विश. तो lecture is timing हो चुकी है. अपना ख्याल रखिए. See you next time, inshallah ta'ala. Love you.